Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Pro Soccer Manager 2016. We are still racing in above 93 or whatever it's called for the rest of the season, obviously. And we have a hilly race where we are actually probably not captain, but maybe we are. I wouldn't make me a captain, I would make me a teammate, honestly, due to low fitness level, but we will see what they decide to do. Too many high heel guys. Here we have a hilly race, three hilly stages followed by one flat stage. So with a bit of luck, Romain Feuillet, our most likely captain, will be able to do well. I doubt it though, honestly.
Greetings to all. The route is fairly hilly, so
teammate,
plenty of action. The race will take place under a bright sun.
And I'm going to protect for you, okay. That is okay. I do not mind having that job for the stage for now. I don't think I'll be able to do anything good in the end anyways, so yeah. And we're apparently riding really hard in the breakaway because our guy up there got dropped. Hopefully he can restore some energy levels and actually do good up there. And not be a waste of time. Well, he seems to have caught up, so that's good. Yeah, he's restoring. Good. Very good. Now, I don't expect much out of this race due to the nature of my fitness level and the skill level of riders involved, but we'll see. Yeah, we'll see what happens. Also, in the meantime, I would like to announce that I now have a new logo. I have channel graphic on YouTube for the first time since YouTube switched to the layout I currently have, meaning they probably switching soon and I have to get it redone again. And I have Twitch channel graphic as well. And I also have new Twitter graphics. It's all designed to look like a, it's all designed with a continuity, and I did not design it myself, I paid for it. So hopefully I can use it for a long as time, because if I had to update it every year, that's going to be expensive in the long run. I mean, it's already expensive, but it's usually worth it if it's just a one-time payment. So, yeah, I'm really happy with it. I think the person that did it did a very good job. Obviously, it's now, well, technically it's the third, but it's 2 AM, so only two stages on Tour de France, and it's already updated on my channel. So, you guys already seen it by, well, if you go to my channel, you'll have seen it by the time this video goes live. Not sure which one it is. I think it's, this should go live 14th or 15th, I think. I do not remember exactly when. Oh, we finished. 9th place, not bad. Green, red, yellow, green, yellow, red, I'm in.
And here are the key moments of the race.
Did I get a gap? I don't think I should have. A gap. Maldonado, where the hell is me? I didn't get a gap. Last rider into the peloton, but with the same time as Lobato. That's good. Let's see. Schedule. Next race. This is... Limousine, right? Yeah. 19th. Then we have the 11th, 18th, and 25th. So, yeah. We are ending with a flat race, and a flat race, and a hilly race. Wow. So this is the second last episode for this first season. Apparently. So it's going to be interesting to see how the next season shapes up. Hopefully I'll get a... level up during the off-season, the 5 months. Well, technically just 3 months, but still.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome! It's an undulating route, so it will be a tactical race. The riders should have a hard day today. The rain is non-stop.
Jackin is the captain for now, apparently. That's weird. Oh well. Yeah, so this is the second to last episode for this season. Next season will be in the Continental Pro Tour. So hopefully. Thank you for staying in the peloton. Stay in the peloton. Hopefully I can get some more higher level races done and get a bit better with level ups. I do think they have taken some critiques seriously, because there's been a lot of complaints about you developing too fast, and I don't think that has been the case for this career, at least. I think if I had done normal development, I would have had 76 mountain, roughly. So, well, the season's not over, but we'll see. One thing's certain, if I picked a U20 youth team, then I would probably be likely to dominate in the mountain stages. Well, not necessarily dominate, but be up there all the time. Thanks for relaxing. You can relax now. Will do, boss. Will do. Maldonado and someone else. Doesn't matter. Oh! Kimeresa fell. Shall now fell. Let's try to make sure that is a bad thing. Attack in the front, that's okay. How's Jackin doing? Oh, he's trying to get climbing points. Okay, I see you. I see what you're doing. If I do that, and can stay in touch over the top. Oh, suck it. Another fall. Yeah, Pekin has fallen. Well, sucks to be you. I'm trying to get a decent result here. Doing my own pace most of the time uphill. Please work, please work, please work. I got the gap.
The finish line is getting close. The riders just passed the 10 kilometers road sign. I think I saw a few riders on the ground.
Come on, hold it. Come on. No. It's a bit too far, sadly.
Superb sprint victory. He was the strongest at the last. The tailenders are still coming in.
But hey, it's just a nice shot. Just a little bit too far up to Hoodie Top.
And here are the race highlights that we've selected for you.
Nice camera angle. Well, 17th isn't too bad, all things considered. Ooh, next one's going to be a rough one. And hey, me and Fayola is actually doing a good race. Wow, Sky came with a strong team.
Hello to one and all. The route is fairly hilly, so there should be plenty
of action. Ooh, plus one. Interesting. I'm not going to sit back this far behind, though. So I'm going to try.
Break away! In all probability, it won't come to much.
To go to the front. Nine riders up ahead. Okay. No one's really riding, but Movistar should be taking point, right? Yeah, double, yeah. I highly doubt I'll be able to get any good position on this stage, but I am not going to stop trying. So, for now, it's just a matter of waiting until the very end. And hopefully the race day condition bonuses are being dealt out in my favor. Also, if you hear me stopping in mid-sentence, I have slept in a bad position tonight, so my back hurts like hell. But that's a story for a different time, I guess. I need 19 seconds. How many seconds is there at the finish line? 10. I need a 9-second gap to the peloton if I were to win this race. Preferably more than a 9-second gap, but at least the 9-second gap. Would have been nice. Time to see what pace they set uphill. Okay, they're starting to ride harder than 70. Interesting.
A couple of teams have set themselves up as pacemakers for the pack. They obviously don't have anybody in the breakaway group.
I just hope that I don't have to spend too much energy just sitting in the peloton. And I hope that the green bar I have is actually going to last. I need six seconds to take the youth jersey. Who is the holder of that actually? Who is that guy? I can't recognize his name. Okay. That guy. Should be possible to drop him. But for now, let's just try to survive.
The pack is increasing its work rate. Some teams can't be happy with the breakaway.
Please don't try too hard, guys. Ah, you're riding too hard, guys. I'm gonna drop.
5 kilometers to the finish line.
Unless I get some energy downhill, please give me energy. Not really, no. But hopefully youth jersey has dropped as well. And no one else comes and takes it, obviously.
There we go. The sprint is on. The riders are setting themselves up. Great stuff! Teamwork really paid off, and their sprinter brings home the bacon.
He's a kid who got bacon. Lucky him. Well, there should be some changes in the overall rankings now. Now just waiting for the rest. There they are, the last 2-1. Within the time limit. By far.
Here are the key moments of the race.
And me... did not do good enough at all. Damn it. I thought I was close, but I wasn't. The finish was too hard. Jesus Christ, my back. Well, this is technically a flat stage. But it's not that flat. I'm gonna try to mess things up in the final stages of this race. If I have a good race day condition. Seems like the top sprinters in this race is mid to high 70s. So, 3rd to 4th grade sprinters.
The profile of this race is quite flat. Expect a fast pace from the peloton.
And of course I have a bad race day condition for the final stage. Also, I want to be a bit further up ahead, please. Distribute it. I'm not attacking, this is way too far for me to ride alone. So, yeah. Isagira has a decent grip on the sprinter's jersey. I doubt Gerald Sheolek is going to be able to do anything about that. Again, it's a relatively hard finish. So don't expect sprinters to finish in the very top. I think trying to go in, depending on how hard the team ride, the Peloton rides in the, I don't care. Depending on how hard the team rides in the later stages. Ooh, Yellow Dress is behind. Interesting. Oh, it made it up. It was behind. So again, before I forget, trying to see how the last part of the race is being done in terms of pace is going to decide my tactics in the finals. If it's slow like now, no problem. If they start to up the pace like crazy, then I have a problem. In fact, I should prepare for that. They've been riding slow so far. Fuck off here. I'm here trying to snatch a stage win for once. A race win, even. Trying is the keyword. I don't think I'll do that. Stage win, maybe. But don't get your hopes up, guys. I started to ride hard. That's not ideal for me. But nothing too hard for now. Okay, three tops left. Okay. And we go down again. And up. Riding slow this time around. Somewhat slow at least. But harder downhill. Alright.
Just happened in the peloton. Several riders are on the ground.
Time to see if I can't make it up.
The finish line is getting close. The riders just passed the 10 kilometers road sign. The escapees have surrendered. The pack gave them no chance. The riders are closing on the last 8 kilometers of the stage, which will most likely end up in a mass sprint.
I didn't get a gap, sadly.
To be very fast.
Yes, so it's no stage room for me. Go for your go. Protect the leader.
Victory for Gerald Chorek.
Chorek got the win. We got third. That's not bad. Roman Fio got third. That's not bad at all. I didn't get the gap to he rode too fast. Sadly. Oh well. Hello, come on, guys. You're gonna go out on time limit. Time limit is over.
And here are the race highlights that we've selected for you.
If there were any. Well, let's see. Did we get a gap? I think 32nd. Only two guys didn't make it. No. Oh well. Thank you guys so much for watching this episode. I hope you have enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time. Take care, everybody.